Tonight, it's going to be a long night. I'm here in Seattle. I finally made it to the West Coast, just a couple states away. How long can it take to cross two states? I'm here with Mal. Hi, Mal.
Hi.
Tonight, we're drinking Jefferson's Reserve.
I can now the really hard part. Oh, you're a master of this, clearly.
I've had practice. Jefferson's Reserve comes from the McLean and Kind Distillery and claims to be very small batch and very old. I'm sure you know what very old means in the world of bourbon,
Certainly,
right?
quite old. Certainly made at some point. Possibly before 0211609 4525.
Indeed. Well, to me, very old means nothing. Doesn't mean anything to me. Jefferson's Reserve is also part of a very small batch, which usually, from the McLean and Kind Distillery, consists of 8 to 12 barrels, which is indeed very small. Most distilleries, when creating small batch bourbons, use 200 to 300 barrels to create their signature blend. Anyway, let's drink. Jefferson's Reserve is a rich amber in color.
Yeah, looks yellow.
So on the nose, I'm getting a lot of butterscotch flavors, a little bit of toffee, and maybe some caramel.
I smell bourbon. Well, we have bourbon.
We do have bourbon.
Oh, we did, yes.
So, are you smelling anything else?
It smells, I guess, light wood, if I would describe it.
I like that. That is
Nice.
really flavorful. It's very fruity.
I can see that. It feels all over the palate, kind of.
It's very fruity and crisp. It's light, but it still has a lot of kick to it.
Yeah, quite, definitely some burn toward the end.
Oh yeah, butter flavors, some grains, a very light caramel or butterscotch flavor.
I can taste that for sure.
And it's very smooth. I enjoy that thoroughly. The aftertaste is pretty long, it's very harsh, and also very oily. I'm noticing that the caramel and a little bit of a tobacco flavor sticks around afterwards.
It tastes very old.
Oh, geez. So, overall, what do you think of it?
Very old.
Very old. I thought it had excellent flavor and excellent balance and a lot of kick. I don't know what kind of bourbon it was in terms of the mash bill, but I suspect it's a high rye. They don't tell us. Jefferson's Reserve is kind of on the high end of mid-range bourbons, so I picked this up for about $40, I think, and you'll probably find it for similar prices, and I would recommend buying it. Maybe not as a daily drinker. It just occurred to me that daily drinker is probably not a phrase normal people have
For bourbon.
for liquor.